Multi-billion dollar company acquires an automation company, says what? Doesn't have a weekly view, says what? I made a weekly view in Notion, says what? Is this what I think it is? Is this a weekly view in Notion? Yeah, it is. So in order to make a weekly view that looks like this in Notion, you're going to need a few properties. So I'm gonna go and make a new page and show you exactly how to make this happen. Make a slash board view. So first and foremost, you're gonna want a formula that is a this week question mark, and then a day of the week formula. Day of the week. And then you're gonna actually wanna have a actual date property, so we can do date or time here. And the this week function basically figures out whether this date is something that's occurring this week or not. So what we're going to do is do a parentheses and then format date, parentheses property, parentheses, and then get that date property that I just made. Another parentheses, comma, quote, week equals equals, and then another format date. Make sure that's right over there, sorry. Format date, parentheses, now, parentheses, close parentheses, comma, another week with quotes, and then this is basically something that's gonna be like the first part of it. This would be what the Boolean would be, but we wanna make it a question. So after the Boolean's done, then we do a question mark, and then we put, quote, this week, and then if not, then this, then not this week. So basically this is saying it would give a check mark or not up to here, like that was the Boolean, and then you make it a question, and if it is this week, then it'll say this week, and if not, it'll say not this week. So as you can see, if I put it on today, it'd say this week. If I put it on next week, it would say not this week. All right, so that's the first step. Then the next thing, we wanna go to the day of the week formula, and you wanna just do a format date, parentheses, property, and then that same property of date, close parentheses, comma, then quote, day, quote, this. And then this will basically spit out the day of the week it is. So as you can see, if I make this a Friday, it'll make it a Friday. If I make it next Monday, it'll make it Monday. Let's work from here to show you the rest of this. So you can do this with anything. You just need a date property in those two. And then what you're going to do is then you go group by day of the week. And when you click on this, you need to press exact instead of alphabetical because it'll only give you one at a time. So then what you're going to do is duplicate this seven times or six times to make it every single day of the week. And then you're going to pick a date throughout this entire week where it's okay, this was Monday, it's Tuesday, it's Wednesday, it's Thursday, this is Friday, Saturday, and then one more to make it a Sunday. So now, because of the way this works and that it's a text property, you're gonna have to manually go in the order that you want. So we're going to click on this and change from sort alphabetical to sort manual, and then go, Sunday for me would be first, Monday, Tuesday, etc. And then I would delete these two. Actually, I'm gonna make this as an example and set this to next Monday, right? So then I'm gonna hide this. So hide the no day of the week. So this is how we get the days of the week. Now I personally wanna make this, go to properties, make the sizes small, just so you can see the whole thing at once. Now you're gonna see there's two of these on Monday. So how can I get it to be this week only? What you're gonna do is go to filter, add a filter where this week question mark is this week. Okay, so that would make it this week exactly. As you can see, it's filtering it out. Now I'm gonna take this guy, show the little status, add another view, duplicate that original board view, call the first one this week, and then you can call the other one maybe next, not this week, if you wanna see like what's not this week for whatever reason. And then for that one, you just change it, the filtering to is not this week. It has to be, it's case sensitive. So as you can see, now we have a weekly view that showcases what is this week and what's not this week. And if you want these to disappear as you complete them, you could obviously filter it to something along the lines of and status is unchecked, so then when I check it off, it would disappear.
If you like this video, make sure to click on this one to see how you can improve your Notion even more.